one block of cream cheese. I'm gonna add some pasta. Dry pasta, uncooked, in one box. And we're gonna top that with some veggies. I've got some red and green bell pepper. These are just some leftover veggies that I had from my previous dinner, and I thought, what can we use to make this yummy? Now I've got some leftover mushrooms. Sprinkle the mushrooms around. Perfect. We're gonna add some red onion, but I'm still waiting for somebody to tell me why they call this red onion, because that's purple, right? Or am I colorblind? Y'all, it looks purple, right? Now you're gonna take your favorite brand of marinara sauce. Now let me know, what is your favorite brand of sauce? And we're just gonna pour the entire jar right on top of our dried pasta and veggies, just like that. One whole jar of sauce. Now I'm gonna top it with some chicken. I'm using this frozen chicken. It's been thawed. It's just easier to use this because it's already prepared and it allows this to cook even quicker. But you could use fresh if you like. Now we're gonna take 2 cups of chicken broth and pour that right over. And you only really need enough to saturate the pasta. And this is a regular 9x13 pan. Kyle, would you do me a favor and get some cheese from the fridge for me, please?
Some cheese? Sure can. Ooh, Parmesan.
Yeah.
Here we go.
We've already got the yummy cream cheese. I think Parmesan's gonna be a nice addition to this as well. But to be honest, this is one where I am just making it from my own creation. This is based on existing recipes that are a no-boil pasta. And you can use all the extra veggies that you have. We're gonna top some Italian seasoning onto this as well. Maybe we should use this side. Some Italian seasoning. And of course, we need some garlic powder. There we go. And just a pinch of salt. I'm using the pink Himalayan sea salt. I wonder if this is better for you. People do say that the pink salt is apparently better for you, but y'all let me know what you think about that. Now we're gonna cover this with foil. I've got my oven preheated to 350 degrees. And we're gonna bake this for about 30 minutes. And because it's covered with foil, that should allow it to stay nice and moist inside there so it doesn't lose all of its liquid. And we're gonna stir it. And of course, if you want, you could top it with more cheese. Now while that's baking in the oven, I've got a pop quiz for you. It's the riddle of the day. Now you gotta think about this one. John is a butcher. He is 5'10" tall and he wears a size 11 shoe. What does he weigh?
Ooh.
Think about that one. Let us know what your guesses are in the comments. John is a butcher. He's 5'10" tall. He wears a size 11 shoe. What does he weigh? Wow. We'll see if you get this one right. All right, y'all, our pasta is done. I can't wait to taste it. I ended up cranking it up to 375, but it really only took about 30 to 40 minutes to bake this, and we are about to find out how it did. I ended up using the macaroni noodles just because that was the ones that I had here. This was a healthier version of this too because we used the high protein pasta and our cream cheese was actually the third less fat, so that cuts down on some calories. All right, y'all ready to see this? Mm-hmm. The foil should help.
Oh, look at that. Right.
But listen, this is when the magic happens. Now you just stir. Look at that. You just give it a stir. See that pasta? It is cooked. And all you have to do is just stir. So now that cream cheese gets mixed with our tomato sauce and it's gonna give us a nice creamy sauce. Look at that, y'all. Look at that. It just got mixed up perfectly. You just throw everything in the pan. No need to boil the pasta first. It happens perfectly right inside the oven.
It's crazy.
This is loaded with veggies. It's healthier. It's lower in fat. And it's got a lot of protein. I can't wait to try this. Now y'all, pasta police, do not come for me because I think it's perfectly fine for you to do it in one dish. But if you prefer to boil your pasta first, you can do that. It's so easy to customize it to your liking. But I think this is ready to eat. Look at that. Ooh, this is gonna be so good.
Let's try this stuff.
Remember what all we got in there? We got our peppers, we got onions, we got mushrooms, we have the cream cheese, we have a little bit of that chicken, and of course, I use the frozen chicken, but you could use fresh chicken if you like, because the name of the game is quick and easy here, but you don't have to always do that. If you want to make it from scratch, heck, you can even make your own pasta. That'd be an adventure. Maybe I should do that one day. We'll see how that goes. All right.
You should put some Parmesan on that.
We should sprinkle some Parmesan as well, yes. But I did Parmesan already when it went in the oven.
I know.
Really?
Yes, all right. This is exciting.
Time for taste testing. Kyle, you're going to get in here, right?
I'm definitely coming in. I love pasta.
This actually looks delicious.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
You want the first bite? It might burn you. Be careful. What's the verdict?
I like it.
It's actually delicious.
It's good. I got some chicken in there. What's not to love, right?
This is
pasta,
really,
chicken.
Really good. I love the cream cheese.
Cream cheese.
With the tomato.
The peppers.
The pasta's perfect. That's al dente. It's exactly what we wanted. So do we think that baked pasta is possibly even better than the regular way? You decide. Let me know what you think in the comments. This one was a winner in our house. I think you're going to like it.
Winner, winner, pasta dinner.
Mm-hmm.